semua. Kali ini saya akan share salah satu best practice yang saya terapkan di kelas saya selama pandemi, terutama terkait dengan assessment ya, atau penilaian mahasiswa. Ya, karena keterbatasan kita tidak bisa melaksanakan penilaian face to face dan tidak bisa juga terlalu banyak melakukan penilaian berbasis tes, karena kita tidak bisa memastikan apakah mahasiswa yang bersangkutan benar-benar melaksanakan atau menjawab ujian sendiri, saya memutuskan lebih banyak menggunakan authentic assessment. Nah, saya pikir sebagian besar kita, para guru atau dosen, sudah paham apa itu authentic assessment. Intinya, authentic assessment adalah bentuk penilaian yang memungkinkan siswa atau mahasiswa kita nilai dengan konteks yang lebih real atau seperti real life situation. Jadi tidak hanya berbasis hafalan, tapi juga berbasis penampilan misalnya. Maka dalam kelas saya lebih banyak menggunakan proyek ya, atau tugas-tugas yang memungkinkan mahasiswa tampil atau perform ya, termasuk juga mereka melakukan misalnya presentasi. Nah, di kelas digital literasi saya meminta mahasiswa untuk mempresentasikan jawaban-jawaban dari soal-soal yang saya berikan ya. Jadi mereka menjawab tidak dengan tertulis tapi dengan lisan ya, melalui presentasi, merekam, kemudian membuatnya dalam bentuk video. Nah, di antara pelajaran di kelas digital literasi saya terkait tentu pertama terkait beberapa teori pengantar tentang apa itu digital literacy. Tapi setelah itu ada banyak skill-skill yang lebih praktis ya, misalnya bagaimana cara mengedit video gitu ya, atau melakukan presentasi secara online yang menarik, atau bagaimana membuat blog atau membuat YouTube channel gitu ya, dan hal-hal praktis lainnya yang diperlukan di dunia saat ini gitu. Nah, berikut adalah satu contoh tugas yang dibikin oleh mahasiswa saya semester kemarin. Ini adalah salah satu menurut saya yang terbaik dan mungkin bisa menjadi sampel bagi Bapak Ibu untuk mengelola atau melakukan penilaian otentik di kelas digital literasi atau literasi digital. Saya posting ini atas izin yang bersangkutan. Semoga bermanfaat. Ya, selamat menonton.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. First of all, I would like to say thank you for Mr. Afrianto Daud as my digital literacy lecturer, and thank you for the opportunity that has been given to me to present my final project assignment. Okay, in this video, I'm gonna be talking about digital literacy class in one semester with Mr. Afrianto Daud.
So guys, have you heard about digital literacy before? I think you have known about it, but maybe there are some of you who don't know what is digital literacy. Let me explain. In the past, human basic needs were only clothes, food, and shelter. But now, in the era of Industrial Revolution 4.0, human basic needs have increased by one. What is it? Yes, the internet. As we know, in this era, we cannot leave behind, especially apart from needs for the internet access, for getting information, transportation, buying and selling transactions, communication and socializing, and many other needs that require internet access. Because this internet can be found anywhere, anytime, and is done by anyone, it certainly makes the information circulating more and more diverse. The information generated includes several types. There is a trusted and actual information, and there's a fake news or hoaxes. This is where digital literacy has a very, very important role. In my opinion, literacy is something that refers to knowledge and skill in certain fields. So, digital literacy is a person's ability and insight in the aspect of using digital technology and communication tools to access, manage, integrate, analyze, and evaluate information in a careful manner and comply with the laws of life. With digital literacy skills, people can use technology optimally and effectively and are fully responsible for what they do. Actually, I've obtained a lot of new knowledge about digital world during one semester in this digital literacy class, such as effective ways to search for information, how to keep safe and secure online and why we need to do that, how to make presentation effective, especially on online presentation, how to create a blog, how to be a YouTuber, what kind of benefit we can have, and how can we start to be a YouTuber. I learned about troubleshooting that I didn't really care about it before, and now I'm becoming more careful in exploring digital world. And I also know about how to back up files online. I also learn about ethics and responsibility as a good internet user. And last but not least, I learn about the future of literacy. Some knowledge that I learned in this semester is about stay saving online. Why we need to be safe online? Because we have to secure our information or data from hackers or random people that may use it for personal needed, or they use it for cyber criminals. For example, if they can access your emails, bank account, or credit cards, you could lose a lot of your money. Or if someone found out your personal information, they could pretend to be you and cause a lot of loss and damage to you. First, you can secure your accounts with strong password, being aware of hoaxes, scams, and tricks. Don't reveal personal information about yourself or anyone else. Only put your information on website that you trust are secure. Be aware of scams and phishing. Don't forget about the risk of ransomware and update the antivirus software. For me, the most interesting topic is how to make presentation effective, especially on online presentation. I like this topic because after I learn, my presentation on each subject becomes good and interesting to look at. I improve my presentation by not too much text on the screen, not too many slides, add some picture or videos, and don't forget to credit. And structure my presentation using sections like introduction, mind body, and conclusion.
Mr. Afrian Todaut used Google Classroom to share the material, and then we discuss it via Google Meet. And after that, if there is additional information, we use the WhatsApp group.
I like Mr. Daud's class, and I think there's no reason not to like this class, because every material and every explanation is very, very interesting, and I'm very happy to learn many things that I didn't know before. And after taking Mr. Daud's class, I've learned many things about digital world. This enables me to use digital world more effectively. Okay, I think that's enough. Thank you so much for your great attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.